If you are tired of spending hours retouching portraits, this one is for you. An AI-powered plugin suite that does the heavy lifting for you. From flawless skin to reshaping the face, it's like having a pro retoucher and it is instant. In this video, I'm breaking down what it does, how it seamlessly integrates with Photoshop and Lightroom. I'll be showing the four standalone apps, Face Make, Heal, Dodge Burn, and Portrait Volumes. Starting with the Face Make here. When you open it, this is the window you get, and you just need to drop your portraits for retouching here. After dropping an image, you see these options to enable on the right. These are very powerful and one-click options. Enabling lifting here, you see immediate changes in the shape of the face, looks a lot younger now. You can change the intensity of the face lifting and also the feminine lifting slider, which gives that exaggerated feminine characteristics to the portrait, and you can control it all and see the results instantly. Holding on this and releasing shows you before and after. Couple more sliders for smoothing and changing the lift of the lips. Now, makeup gives you a lot more options and it is fun to play with. There are separate sections for eyes, lips and skin. Each has a pop down to choose the options, or you can click on these arrow buttons to move from one option to another. And the results are immediate. Each effect looks very natural and it's just a personal preference to choose, and you should be ready to go. Even with the slanted angle of the face, the AI detects the eyes and applies each effect really well. Choosing the bright underline option here, you can change the hues of the color with the hue slider. Change the intensity of the effect with the depth slider. Now to the lips. All the options look so natural here. Lot of options to choose and personalize accordingly. Burgundy Nights goes well with the makeup on the eyes. Fine tuning further with the sliders below. In the skin options, you can add subtle freckles to enhance the face further. And with the depth slider, the intensity of those freckles. There are other options to choose, like adding glow and color to the skin. Displays has further options to change the shape of the eyes, nose or the lips. You can make it more subtle by controlling with the depth slider. There is also the mesh icon to view the applied neural mesh on the face. Change the brush size and you can manually change the shape of the face. If you aren't satisfied, there is an undo button. You can see the changes we made here. You can notice there is still room to perfect the face, like the minor skin defects. So now I'll save this image and open the standalone Retouch4me Heal app. Drag the saved image here, and the auto mode has done its job already. Zooming in here to see the difference before and after. You can see it looks so subtle and natural. With the sensitivity slider, you can see the mask and the spots where the changes were made. If you want to exclude any spots from the effect, you can choose the eraser option and brush on the chosen spots, and you see now this particular spot remains as it is. You can bring it back with the brush tool. There's an option to invert the mask as well. Now I will save this and import it to the Dodge Burn app. There's already a difference here. You can see here the shadows and the lights have smoothened out itself in an instant. This particular step would take a ton of time on Photoshop and one of the major edits done on portraits. Takes hardly a second or two to get the results here. With the default settings, the highlights and shadows corrected look natural. If you want to further smoothen it out, you can drag the blend slider further, which makes the light more even on the face. There are more options for the type of portrait to choose, though the auto option works really well. There is one more plugin to take this portrait to next level, Portrait Volumes. You can already see the difference. Basically, it adds light to the face and creates depth by adding shadows, which makes the image more three-dimensional. You can make the light and shadows more prominent by moving the blend slider towards right. Right around the middle gives you a subtle effect and looks a lot more natural. You can toggle this mask icon to see where the visuals of the light and shadows clearly. A very handy option. And with all the four plugins applied on the same portrait, the difference it makes with the added makeup, removing imperfections on the skin, smoothing out the light with dodge and burn, and then adding subtle light and shadows to add depth to the portrait. Stunning results, and it hardly takes a minute to get this. One more handy feature to show here. For example, I applied dodge and burn on this portrait, and what if I want to apply this to a lot more portraits too? I just need to drag and drop those right here, and the same tunings are applied on all these. Batch processing works quite well here. You can further tune them individually if you prefer. Really impressed with the results. I'll next show you a more easier way to use these plugins in Photoshop. I have this portrait imported to Photoshop. I'll do some basic tuning to bring some brightness back to this image. Correcting the temperature too. I have already the Retouch4me plugins installed. Clicking on this to reveal all the plugins. Here, instead of doing it one by one, I will at a time choose the three plugins, Heal, Dodge and Burn, and Portrait Volumes, and enable them, tapping on the Retouch button. It takes a couple of seconds, and the results are here. Not only the look, but you get three extra layers of these effects applied. You can see the heal layer where the spot healing has been done, dodge and burn layer where the 50% gray layer and the blend mode to soft light is set. Similarly, portrait volumes for depth. You can also change the intensity of each effect applied by changing the opacity of each layer. This is such a well thought out of feature. This literally saves hours of retouching work which is normally done on Photoshop to something like a minute or two. Makes such a huge difference. These plugins does work on Lightroom too. Opening an image here in Lightroom, going to the photo menu, editing, here you find all the plugins installed. Just need to choose one here, for example, Face Make. This directly takes the image to the Face Make standalone app. After doing all the retouching needed, you need to just save it and it takes it back to the Lightroom where you can continue with further edits or you can even use other plugins to make the retouching easier. And there's a special discount for you all to try the Retouch4me apps yourselves. Check the promo code link in the video description for an exclusive 25% discount. And I hope the video was useful to you all and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.